Prior to performing the ThermiTight procedure, we prep the patient's lower face and neck with a betadine solution. Next, a tumescent anesthesia solution of your choosing is instilled through the lateral ports in the neck to get the lateral neck as well as jowls and the central or medial port or pilot hole submentally. This is the ThermiTight cannula, which in this case was used to instill the tumescence. It's an 18 gauge size and it's about 10 centimeters in length. This is then used to create dry passes through the neck in order to create a plane preplatysmal that the probe is going to pass through the neck in. This pre-tunneling allows the probe to move so it's not hung up on any of its attachments in the subcutaneous plane. Next, the RF element is then placed into the cannula and inserted into the lateral port in the neck. During the procedure, a FLIR thermal camera is then used to watch the temperature in the neck while the heat is being introduced. As you can see on this screen, we have begun to start the procedure from the right lateral neck. There is a crosshairs that shows up on the FLIR screen, as you can see, which measures the temperature of the neck at about 4 times per second. This crosshair flies to the hottest part in the neck. During the procedure, we're actually trying to heat the fibroseptal network underneath the skin up to around 65 to 70 degrees Celsius deep. That temperature allows us to both contract the fibroseptal network through neocollagenesis and the production of new collagen, as well as melt some of the subcutaneous fat. During the procedure, you can see we are simultaneously looking at the FLIR camera image, as well as looking at the neck to see how the skin and soft tissue is responding during the procedure. For each of the passes, the probe is advanced at the farthest point into the neck and slowly retracted at about a 3 to 5 second interval. On this side of the neck, you can see that the max temperature of the skin is now about 42.8 degrees Celsius. We're beginning to reach our endpoint, which is a temperature throughout our treated area of the neck of around 42 to 45 degrees Celsius of the skin. That corresponds to either a 65 or 70 degrees Celsius temperature deep. After the lateral neck is treated, the submental area is also treated in that same subcutaneous or preplatysmal plane. Because the platysma is dehiscent in the midline, you can angle the probe more deeply into some of the subplatysmal fat in order to help melt that as well. Following the procedure, you can see mild blanching in the neck and the 3 cannula pilot holes.